Good morning, church. I want to welcome you to worship this 10th Sunday after Pentecost. It's been a very stormy week here in the New York area, and it is my hope and my prayer that you are well and that your electricity is back on in your home, and so you can recharge your devices or at least be able to view this worship service on this beautiful day. Just to let you know that there have been some damages to our church property due to a fallen branch. This is a little picture that was taken on Wednesday. You can see there that the tree on the 120th Street corner, one of the branches snapped, fell on the fence and smashed our little sign at the corner. There are a couple other minor pieces on the church building that needed to be repaired, some guttering and so on. Thanks to Scott Campbell, Don Broadmarkle, and Moses Cargi, we've got everything cleared away. And of course, thanks to Edith, who stopped by to see how we were doing in the cleanup efforts as well. So having said that, welcome again to worship, and let us begin with a greeting. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. O God, our defender, storms rage around and within us and cause us to be afraid. Rescue your people from despair. Deliver your sons and daughters from fear and preserve us in the faith of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Let us join together in singing our hymn of praise, How Great is Our God. Let us sing together.
The splendor of the King, clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide. Trembles at his voice, and trembles at his voice. How great is our God! Sing with me, how great is our God! And all will see how great is our God! Thank you.
The psalm for today, the 10th Sunday after Pentecost, comes to us from Psalm 85, beginning to read at the 8th verse. Let us read together Psalm 85. I will listen to what the Lord God is saying. For you speak peace to your faithful people and to those who turn their hearts to you. Truly, your salvation is very near to those who fear you, and your glory may dwell in our land. Steadfast love and faithfulness have met together. Righteousness and peace have kissed each other. Faithfulness shall spring up from the earth, and righteousness shall look down from heaven. The Lord will indeed grant prosperity, and our land will yield its increase. Righteousness shall go before the Lord and shall prepare for God a pathway. Amen. Our gospel reading comes to us from Matthew, the 14th chapter, beginning to read at the 22nd verse. The Holy Gospel according to Matthew, the 14th chapter. Jesus made his disciples get into the boat and go ahead to the other side while he dismissed the crowds. And after he had dismissed the crowds, he went up to the mountain by himself to pray. When evening came, he was there alone. But by this time, the boat, battered by the waves, was far from the land, for the wind was against them. And early in the morning, he came walking toward them on the sea. But when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified, saying, "It is a ghost." And they cried out in fear. But immediately Jesus spoke to them and said, "Take heart, it is I. Do not be afraid." Peter answered him, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." He said, "Come." So Peter got out of the boat, started walking on the water, and came toward Jesus. But when he noticed the strong wind, he became frightened, and beginning to sink, he cried out, "Lord, save me." Jesus immediately reached out his hand and caught him, saying to him, "You of little faith, why did you doubt?" When they got into the boat, the wind ceased. And those in the boat worshipped him, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." The Gospel of our Lord. Grace, mercy, and peace to you in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Amen. Tell me, who has been thinking about back to school? I know, this would be the last thing on your mind in early August, but for many of us, this year is different. It's different because of COVID-19. Everyone is focused on the safety of students, the safety of teachers, the safety of other staff, and even the bus driver. Schools are sacred places, right up there with churches. And we are also engaged in similar efforts to find the best and safest means of worshiping together again. We are thinking about how we can clean, how we can prevent physical contact with potential harmful pathogens. Whether we realize it or not, COVID-19 has caused and continues to cause tremendous stress in our world. It has taken on a certain personality of its own, consuming us and having a lot of our attention. Speaking about personality, in today's gospel reading, we encounter Peter. Yes, the very talkative disciple of Jesus, the former fisherman. Most of us would remember him by his famous denial of Jesus three times before the cock crowed that early morning. But there's much more to Peter's character. We hear in our gospel reading today, and I couldn't help to think about why? Why would Peter want to walk on water? Why would Peter want to get out of the boat? You would think that a fisherman would know better, and that he wouldn't be able to defy physics by walking on the water. Well, the answer to this question is found in the first verse that we read, in verse 22. Jesus made his disciples get into the boat and go ahead to the other side. Go ahead to the other side. And maybe Peter is another Jonah bailing on this mission. For you see, for Matthew's audience, the image of a boat represented the church, the vessel bearing the good news to the world. The church, yes, you and me. And Jesus made his closest followers get into that boat, and then he launched them. He launched them on a mission to go to the other side. And I know what you're thinking. Why would Jesus send them to the other side? What's on the other side? Who's on the other side of the Sea of Galilee? Well, I'll tell you who's there. The Gentiles are there. The Gentiles are there. On the other side of the sea are those who have never heard the good news. Those who have never experienced the love of God in Jesus. On the other side of the sea, it's just like outside our church doors, because that's where the other, people who are different from us, are waiting to hear the good news. Now, for any who has ever embarked on such a mission to bear witness to Jesus to the world, you would agree that this mandate to go on the other side was not easy. Such a mission was not easy, but necessary. Necessary as a called out and sent disciple of Jesus. More than ever today, there is a need for the church to respond to this mandate. Now is the time to launch or to relaunch into the world with a message of salvation that God has offered through Jesus the Christ. The Apostle Paul, in a letter to the Romans, chapter 10, had this to say about being such a witness. He says, "We are called by God to bring good news of Jesus to all nations." But how? How are we to call on one on whom we have not believed? And how are they to believe in the one whom they have not heard of? And how are they to hear without someone proclaiming him? And how are they to proclaim him unless someone is sent? As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of those who bring good news. How beautiful. It has been a long and sometimes frustrating journey for the church. And St.James-St.Matthew Lutheran Church is no different. All of us are living in some troubled time, confusing time, uncertain times right now. In the midst of a pandemic, in the midst of sirens blaring all around us, it was not smooth and pleasant when the first church began, or when the first disciples were launched, and it is not for us as well. But they were launched nonetheless. It was a stormy night for them, battered by the waves and the wind, terrified, and they cried out in fear. in the midst of the most difficult of circumstances, in the midst of life-threatening moments, Jesus came to their rescue. Peter and the other disciples, in the battle of their lives, in the midst of their fears, was rescued by Jesus. And in the midst of our own fears today, in the midst of our own confusion, in the midst of our own uncertainty of life, Jesus shows up for us. Like he did with his first disciples, Jesus is showing up to us and saying to us this day, take heart. Do not be afraid. It is I. It is I. Amidst the winds and the storms, amidst the turmoil of this life, amidst the pandemic, Jesus is saying to you, take heart. Do not be afraid. It is I. I am here with you. And as promised, will be with you to the end of the age. Amen. Let us join together in singing the hymn of the day, Jesus Savior, highlight me. Let us sing together.
By the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Confident in God's care and help of the Holy Spirit, we now bow our heads and lift our hearts in prayer for the church, the world, and for all who are in need. And again, your response being, hear our prayer. Let us pray. For your whole church throughout the world, O God, we give you thanks. And we pray that you give us courage in the midst of storms and even in the midst of a pandemic. Give us relief in the wake of Isaias, so that we may see and hear Jesus calling, do not be afraid. May we follow Christ wherever he leads. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For the nations and their leaders, we pray. In you, steadfast love and faithfulness meet, and righteousness and peace kiss. May nations in conflict know the peace that is the fruit of justice, and the justice that is the path to peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For those in need, everyone who calls upon your name will be saved. Accompany all who are lonely. Hear the voices of those who cry out in anguish, and support those who are frustrated in their search for COVID-19 relief and for affordable places to live. We pray for those who are suffering this day, and especially those in Beirut, Lebanon. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For our congregation, St.James-St.Matthew Lutheran Church, you have gathered us via Zoom and YouTube, and for this we thank you. We thank you for the gift of technology. We also pray for those who are seeking new communities, for those students and teachers preparing for a new school year, and for those struggling with unexpected hardship and difficult decisions this day. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We give you thanks, O God, for the saints of the whole church from all time and places, and for the saints in our lives and in our communities whom you have gathered to yourself. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. In the certain hope that nothing can separate us from your love, O God, we offer these prayers to you. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who taught us to pray, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And until we meet again, dear friends, be safe, be well, and take care of each other during these summer months. And just to let you know, in the next week or so, we'll be making a decision as to when we will resume in-person worship. It is my hunch it could be September. The numbers are trending in the right direction. And thanks be to God. Now receive a blessing. God, the Creator, Jesus, the Christ, and the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, bless and keep you in eternal love. Amen. Now let us sing together our closing hymn, You Have Come Down to the Lake Shore. Let us sing together. Smiling.
shame.